You'll never get me to stop. You'll never get me to shut my mouth. Cause once I learned I could talk, I got most of my demons out. Instead of kicking myself, beating me up inside, I let the words fall out cause I don't like to hide. I live my life like an open book, and that might bother you. Maybe that inspires you. I live my life in the way I want. And if that bothers you, you don't have to read it through. I'm an open book. Feel free to take a look. I'm a free-for-all, what are secrets even for? You'll never get me to change. Once I saw my life and it was better, never get me to rearrange. I'll admit I'm a little stubborn. I feel my best when I tell the whole truth about me. I've learned it hurts to lie, and honesty makes me happy. I live my life like an open, and that might bother you. Maybe that inspires you. Live my life in the way I want. And if that bothers you, you don't have to read it through. I'm an open book. Feel free to take a look. I'm a free-for-all, what are secrets even for? I live my life like an open book, and that might bother you. Maybe that inspires you. I live my life in the way I want. And if that bothers you, you don't have to read it through.
Thank you.
So the one thing we did not talk about before we went on the air, and I should backtrack and do the reintro after the first song. This is WEFT Champaign 90.1 FM. You are listening to Web Sessions, and your name is no longer in front of me, so this is my test whether I can remember it. E2 Mo Elmari.
Almost.
Almost.
To Moo Elmari.
Why don't you explain to the listeners how you came up with that so that they can remember too?
Okay, so basically, before I was born, my mom was searching through baby name books, and Itumu was one she kind of held on to.
Oh,
I
it's
guess.
All together. I thought it was Itumu. Mm-mm. It's Itumu.
It's Itumu.
I was thinking like U2 with Bono.
I mean, I have a U2 tattoo, so.
I started to ask where, but that is a question that might be really awkward.
That's
so
okay.
I'm not going to ask that.
It's on my ribcage. It's fine.
Okay.
No, my dad was a huge U2 fan, so that would make a little bit of sense. But no, Itumu, it means little bear dancing in the sunshine,
okay.
Which is super, super cute.
Yeah.
And that kind of stuck with her, and my nickname has been Bear in my family since day one.
B-E-A-R.
Mm-hmm. It's still my nickname. That's all my family calls me. But, and then Elmari is just Marielle, but switched around.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Itumu Elmari.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's easier when I can process it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But, I mean, that's how it is with most language. Like, most languages are more phonetic than English. Like almost all of them.
Yeah, that's very true.
And, you know, if you just know, do you apply the German rules? Do you apply the Mandarin rules? You know, because I know people, they took French and they just try to make everything French, right? They took German and they try to make everything German. And it's like, no, you don't pronounce Spanish German. That just doesn't work. It's fun, but it's wrong. Anyway, so Itumu Elmari?
Correct.
Okay, we're just going to go with that.
Okay.
I think we've got it now. So, this is your first time on WEFT Sessions? Is it your first time on WEFT?
It's my first time solo on WEFT.
So, you were with what other act?
I was with Wolves to Whales.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Appropriate?
Yeah.
And So welcome back.
Thank you.
How have you been?
I've been pretty well. My life has been kind of crazy, but...
A lot of people's, seems like, lately.
That's very true, also.
So what I started to ask was, we didn't establish whether you want to talk after every song, every three songs, whether you want me to take a trip, you know, to the moon and not come back until 11 o'clock. Because I want you to be able to talk as little or as much as you want, as long as you fill the hour with your original creative contribution. So
it can be every few songs. That's fine.
You want to say every two?
Sure.
Because we're talking
two.
Enough now, just explaining to people that this is the show and that you're on and you're based in...
Champaign now. Yes.
Were you at U of I before that?
I went to school in Winona, Minnesota.
Oh, wow. What school?
St. Mary's University of Minnesota. I'm part of an artist collective out of there. We're called Tree Dome Productions.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And then I came back here, and then I moved to Iowa for a very short amount of time. That wasn't too fun, and then I moved back here.
I have said once or twice, growing up, Iowa was my favorite state, and then I went there. It's a much meaner story than the reality, which is I went there and it's like, it's okay. It wasn't like it was dead to me. It's just like, whatever corn on the cob fantasy I had when I was 3 years old, it's just kind of Midwestern without like making me want to give up my life here, you know?
Yeah.
So I feel like it's a funny story, but people could totally take it the wrong way if they're from Iowa, so.
Yeah.
Yes. Humbly G loves you, Iowa, and we'll go with that. So
good enough.
Anyway, so you want to go on to two more songs?
Sure, let's do that.
I will be getting the Johnny Cash and the Rolling Stones and the Beatles and the Beach Boys ready.
Okay.
You just tell us what you're gonna play, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
This next one is called Suddenly. Okay. Trying to define something so divine. Is it possible to put a name on it? Dictionaries fail when new words try to avail, and letters get mixed up along the way. I could try to say what it is on my mind, but that would require something more. And my anxiety and awkwardness will get into the way. So what do I say? What do I say? Suddenly you mean the world to me, and I could sing about it endlessly. Become my muse, you have, honestly. Suddenly I'm trapped inside a box of happy. You've brought me in, it won't release me. But am I even mad, honestly? How could I be? Attempting to find something hidden in your mind, something shoved off to the side for so long. Boys confuse me so, and I will never know why you managed to pick me and make me yours. I could try to say what's nagging me, but that would require some confidence out of me. I could sing about it endlessly.
close all of these nights. Please, please, please come with me now to far off places where I'm wild. I'll let you see the insides of me that I hide for now, so you'll never judge me.
Okay, time to go back to a classic. This is Chasing Smoke.
We're two different planets, never meant to collide. Accretion wasn't meant to be here, we both need our own time. When I'm in your atmosphere, I should really stay farther away. Even though it's because of you I've changed. Whoa, I've changed. Got all your eyes open and you're staring at the sea. Fire in your heart, but you're clouded constantly. In my dark room at night, I breathe in and I choke. At the end of the day, I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing. I end up chasing. I refuse to stain you with my dirty hands. You're too perfectly painted, traveling across the lands, collecting memories to later be thrown away. I've dug my claws in deep and I'm hoping you'll let me stay. You're clouded constantly. In my dark room at night, I breathe in and I choke. At the end of the day, I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing. I end up chasing. In freezing twilight, I can finally see why there cannot exist an uninterrupted you and me. The evergreens block out the light from behind as you attempt to explain the madness of our minds. The madness of my mind. Got all your eyes open and you're staring at the sea. In your heart, but you're clouded constantly. In my dark room at night, I breathe in and I choke. At the end of the day, I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing. Got all your eyes open and you're staring at the sea. Fire in your heart, but you're clouded constantly. In my dark room at night, I breathe in and I choke. At the end of the day, I end up chasing smoke. I end up chasing smoke. up chasing, I end up chasing smoke.
Thank you.
Chair didn't want to let me up. I went to get up and I right back down. So I wanted to say, okay, let's see if I can do this again. Itumu El Mare?
Correct.
Okay.
Yay!
So, and I did not, people in the studio actually know I was not relying on cue cards that time. So, if I may, I made this observation maybe 10 years ago and I still feel like it came out wrong, but it's always impressive to me when there's somebody on the show who has not at least appeared solo before, mm-hmm. who not only can sing really well, but where that's on display and not like disguised with heavy, you know, drums and bass and distortion and all. So I'm impressed. I wish I could do that.
Thank you.
So
I appreciate that.
However you use your talent, it's clearly on display tonight.
Thank you.
So anything you want to tell people that we didn't already cover? Maybe where they can book you?
Social yes. media?
He knows the drill.
I update my SoundCloud uh-huh. more than anything. I have my original EP when I was...
Could you give out your SoundCloud? Because yes. just because I can pronounce your name doesn't mean people are going to know how to look it up.
Yes, it's soundcloud.com/Itumu El Mari, which is Itumu Elmari.
All right. And mm-hmm. are you on other... are there other ways, places that link to that?
I'm on Facebook. I should have a link on my Facebook page. Hopefully. I haven't checked that.
Are there a lot of Itumus where you have to be like Itumu El Mari 45 or,
Thank goodness, no.
Okay.
There's a reason that I'm not just going by my first name. I'm pretty sure there's a Latin American singer just going by Mariel.
Okay.
Which is why I couldn't.
is that spelled like Mariel Hemingway or do you get asked that a lot?
I think hers has one less L-E than mine does.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, Marielle.
Mm-hmm.
Got it. French-like.
Yes.
That's actually, I don't think I've ever seen that. That's interesting.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
I mean, she's the only one I can think of offhand, so.
Yeah. It's not a common name.
Anyway, any upcoming gigs you want to promote?
I'm actually playing on Friday. We are doing it's a benefit for, what is it, Planet Music? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's trying to raise money to be a better household.
It's almost like other people here already knew that.
Yeah, it's almost like you should come and talk about right. that.
And I should also add, I feel weird because Humbly G is this way, and I have, well, I did have a bunch of people behind me that I want to give equal, I want to make equal eye contact, but the way the mic is turned, it's, I don't know, they're not getting equal time. So, anyway, any of you did you want people to come up and talk about it with you?
Yeah. How about, yeah, you should come up and talk about Friday.
So on Friday, you can just find us in Urbana on a house show going on with a bunch of local people. Kenna May is going to be there. Uh-huh. She's fantastic. We've got Garrett, who is known more around campus. We've got a guy whose first gig it is. We've got Jarring, a local indie band that's going to be playing all acoustic. And then we've got a DJ closing the night out. And Planet Music Benefit, you can find us on Facebook.
And would you mind giving... the house address, which windows are left unlocked, and where valuables are
one
stored?
One on the left, it's the one on Bob Street.
Okay, great. I always like to both make sure people are able to attend concerts and also compromise as much confidential information and inconvenience people as much as possible.
Perfect.
And there actually are people who probably aren't familiar enough with me to know that I'm being facetious, so if you... want to write angry letters, please send them to someone besides me. I can't imagine anybody saying that with a straight face and not being in severe need of heavy medication. Oh, I mean, that's just a jerk thing to, you know, unless you're kidding. It'd just yeah. be weird. It's like, why would you even? Okay, so anyway. I don't know. It totally kills a joke if you have to explain that you didn't mean it, but...
Oh, well.
You know, I obviously... That, I mean, I would promote more house shows if not for the fact that people's security is important. So, anyway, I hope the people that... Yes. Back to you.
Okay.
Well, I mean, the idea is, you know, whenever you're ready.
Yeah,
so
okay.
That's why I'm just rambling here and digging a deeper and deeper hole.
That's okay. Okay.
Maybe it's fun to watch. I don't know.
Okay, I have the next song I'm going to be playing is Poison, and then the song after that is called B, and that's when 94 Cove is going to come up.
Okay, now, this is not a cover of the band Poison. The song is called Poison.
The song is called Poison, correct.
With an S.
Yes.
I have a listener who once spelled it with a Z and is still traumatized.
That's kind of cool, though, spelling it with a Z.
It was before creative band names were a thing. So.
Okay. It was too early.
Yeah, she was ahead of her time. In a lot of ways. Hi, Mom.
Water flowing from out of my soul. Filled with demons, drowning in cold. Haven't beat them, but haven't backed down. I accept that they'll be around. Water flowing from out of my mind. Filled with monsters, the likes you won't find. Haven't beat them, but haven't succumbed to their chanting and their wild drums. I won't let myself down. I've gone through too much without hitting the ground. I won't let myself drown. Too much has been thrown at me to not hit the ground. So close, I've tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, had the demons poised. I've been so close, I've tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, would have not woke up for so long. Fire flowing from out of my soul, filled with bombs and knives and holes. Never expected to see them myself, but who would have known half of what's already come out? Fire flowing from out of my mind, filled with terrible creatures from different times. Never expected to see them myself, but little did I know I had worse inside that I haven't let out. I won't let myself down, I've gone through too much without hitting the ground. I won't let myself drown. Too much has been thrown at me and not hit the ground. I've been so close, I've tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, had the demons poised. I've been so close, I've tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, would have not woke up for so long. I won't let myself down. I won't let tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, had the demons poised. I've been so close, I've tasted it, put the poison on my tongue. I've been so close, almost wasted this, would have not woke up for so long.
Thank you. You ready? Okay. Okay, 94 Cove, you want to plug in? We're getting ready.
Oh, God.
He's excited. He's ready.
Is this it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I should be able to do this. That's a fun noise. Oh, this is exciting. This is a collab first. I really hope my grandma's listening right now. She said she was going to stay up. And that made me really happy. So, if you're listening, hi Bucky.
we need the version just the instrumental, right?
Yes. Okay. Clicking through the buttons, and then we're gonna play.
Oh, so excited, and then we're gonna play.
Oh yeah, and for those of you who want to come to the show on Friday, the show starts at 10:30 until 1 a.m. Are we good? Is it working? It's making funky noises. Yeah, I'm ready.
To drift away, you dragged me back, asked me to stay. I'd rather be floating in outer space. I wanted to run away, you pulled me back, begged me to stay. I'd rather be sinking in the waves. Something more, wonder what's in store. Ba-dum-bum, ba-dum-bum, bum-bum-bum. Bum-bum-bum-bum-bum.
So much for the lights and the action. So much for the cameras flashing. So much for your satisfaction. One question I gotta ask it. Do you still care for me? I said, do you still care for me? 'Cause I come to you as a man. Here I am, here I stand. Revising whole situation. Going back and forth to strengthen our foundation. Brick by brick, piece by piece. If it was up to me, I wouldn't let you leave. Up to me, I wouldn't set you free. If it was up to me, I wouldn't let you. Because with these hands, you know I built these walls up. With these hands, I held you at the altar. With these hands, I'll divide and conquer. I'm a lyrical monster. How the hell you stop the pride inside me? 'Cause it's still intact. Pride inside me, 'cause I got it like that. Pride inside me, you can hold my ass. Pride inside me, you can hold my ass.
You know, I didn't think of it until you guys went on together, but 94 Cove almost sounds like a rival station. Can you, like, 94 Cove, you know? if you just had your little, what do you call that? Like, all the cues that a lot of radio stations would have. You know, WEFT. I don't know if... We've never really done that, but... yeah, clearly. That's what's keeping us from the big bucks.
What was that? I said the name of the last two songs. Yeah, I did.
Actually, could I just work in one quick thing?
Yes.
So I do want to thank everybody. The past 2 weeks have been our pledge drive. I was hoping to have a total tonight. I don't see an updated total. I see the same total that was from the weekend. But we had at least four donations through the show. We normally don't have them at night, late at night. Mm-hmm. So I want to thank everybody who's given and tell people that technically you can still give because you can give all year long, but we're going to stop bugging you about it so much. But this was probably our most difficult pledge drive, so everybody who gave, you matter even more than usual, probably. It's really appreciated, and each donation was a pretty sizable percentage of the overall total. So thank you, and here's to staying on the air.
Yay! Yay.
But yeah, maybe if we just had little stings and little cues where we sang our name, we would be raking in more money than we already are. We should contract out.
Oh, no, the speaker was business. How much it was me, like.
So he mentioned something about the last two songs.
Yes,
and
okay. So the one that was just me, it was called Poison.
Right.
And the one with
Poison.
94 Cove. Yes. The one with 94 Cove was called B. Mm-hmm.
Actually, that... I'm sorry, what?
He's just trying to get me to talk.
Okay. I was going to mention, here I'm kind of making light of Poison, but my degree is in Italian, mm-hmm. and I think it took finishing college to realize that a single S and a double S are pronounced totally differently because I just had the English mindset. Well, and that's, once again, that's French. But I would tell people I lived on Via Rimese, and it was Rimese, and people literally didn't know what I was talking about. They'd be like, I've never heard of that street, and I'd write it down, and they'd be like, oh, that's not what you said. So it actually is, I mean, it's almost like the difference between a B and a V, or a B and mm-hmm. a P. So yeah, the fact that Poison is pronounced like it would make sense to spell it with a Z is kind of a failing of English.
Yeah. Oh, the English language.
And you can never build your brand yourself too much on this show. So let's tell everybody your name again
okay.
so they know who to thank.
I am Itumu Almari. You can check me out on Facebook. It's Itumu Elmari. Real name is Marielle. I'm from Champaign. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I do play at the open mics at Canopy Club basically every week now.
All right. What night is that?
It's Monday nights.
Oh. Well, I guess I can't go.
Yeah. Probably going there after this.
One of my favorite bands that used to play on Web Sessions a lot got a Monday night residency at the Canopy Club. So I went from having like perfect attendance seeing them to missing them every time they played. Once I got there for their last song, because they finished... like 10 minutes after my show ended,
mm-hmm.
somebody rushed me over there, like, you know, Death Cab for Cutie. and I got there and they played one song. I'm like, we're done. It's like, gee, it's one song. You know, I finally got to see them play again.
Well, that's cool.
And now they've been broken up for like 10 years. So.
Wow. Ouch.
He had to go
in and
get a new relationship.
Yes, yes. I think my girlfriend will be glad to know that.
My man's on the road.
I could get all metaphysical, but I really don't want to. Go on, please.
Okay. Yeah. This next one is called Aura.
Uh-huh.
I don't think I've ever performed this song, actually.
Wow. Everybody, moment of... we need a drum roll. We need our cues and stings to have a fake drum roll.
I was going to attempt to make the noise, and then I realized that would probably be embarrassing, so I'm not going to do that.
Okay. But yes, this is a worldwide, this is your international debut of Aura.
Yes. I mean, I've had a very bad version on my SoundCloud for a while, but...
Now, this is A-U-R-A. This is not how some people in rural areas pronounce the 18th letter of the alphabet.
No.
Good.
Okay. This is Aura.
I won't be silenced, I won't be pushed to the side. I want an answer, and I refuse to hide. I have this power, I want to be inside. Radiate flowers, so why do you wait? I wanna tingle your senses, wanna catch your eye. I'm making my way under your skin, ready to slip inside. I wanna tingle your senses, you have no reason to fear. Only wanna take care of you, my dear. I fell in love with your aura, I could see it at once. And once I felt I could move in, I was blazing guns. I refuse to be silenced, you should honor my touch. Once you accept me, baby, then you can't get enough. I wanna tingle your senses, wanna catch your eye. I'm making my way under your skin, ready to slip inside. I wanna tingle your senses, you have no reason to fear. Only wanna take care of you, my dear. Senses, wanna catch your eye. I'm making my way under your skin, ready to slip inside. I wanna tingle your senses, you have no reason to fear. Only wanna take care of you, my dear.
Thank you. That's a little baby song. little short one. Okay. Now, this song is called Clockwork. This is like hardcore throwback song for me.
Simply floating in the space found in between. But do we really need a definition if both of us are perfectly happy? This situation calls for no comparisons. We are our own, and that's what matters. As we commit our sins, we fall asleep in seas of dark blue. Wide awake when we finally come to. And I see your face, and suddenly I'm better. You're just another prescription for me when I'm under the weather. This is the first time in my life I've tried living day by day, and it's paying off in every wonderful way. 'Cause I'm trying my best to live in the moments with you, but occasionally I drift into the future. I can't help but do. You and I go along like clockwork, at least from my perspective, and every second together is pure bliss. You help me out, I try my best, create our love without the rest. These silly definitions can move to the side, 'cause all that matters is we're together on this ride. I daydream about the possibilities, the road trips where we venture to the sea, wandering the vast unknown in color, sharing greens and blues with one another. I've been told I can't entrust my happiness in others, and I agree now. But feel the joy inside, in your eyes, see into mine. Days go by and weeks go by and months have gone by, and I'm not tired yet, and I hope we ride this out to the full extent of time. I like when you're here with me, I like when we drink our tea, and I like when we share the greens. I like when we watch TV, and you're complex in different ways than me. All the layers to both of us mesh perfectly. You and I go along like clockwork, at least from my perspective, and every second together is pure bliss. You help me out, I try my best, create our love without the rest. Those silly definitions can move to the side, 'cause all that matters is we're together on this ride. This ride.
Thank you. Fun fact about that song, it is on my first EP, when I still went by MARI3113, still pronounced Marielle. I wrote that song 5 minutes before I went in to record with my friend who was producing the album. Or EP, yeah. I just kind of was like, hey, I want a different song than what I've already written, so I'm gonna write this one. And that's how that song happened.
It's always neat when that works out. I am a fan of fun facts, but I'm also a fan of fun facts that are actually fun. One of the worst things I ever saw, and I think it went viral, this was like 10 years ago. It was a retrospective on Family Ties, and they said, fun fact, Michael J. Fox has been battling, you know, Parkinson's for like 10 years, and all these people wrote in, and they were like, do you understand what a fun fact is, you know, that it's supposed to actually be fun and not, like, mortifying?
And not just, hey, random tidbit.
Or not even random so much as, like, deeply upsetting.
Yeah.
So not that, I mean, I think people already knew that, but I mean, for heaven's sake, so.
That's not something you just.
Right.
Start off with fun fact.
Right. And I mean, I suppose there are ironic fun facts, but that wasn't even ironic. That was just inappropriate. So thank you for an actually fun fact that delivered.
No problem. Happy to help.
I like to think most of the conversation breaks on the show are fun facts and not awkward, inappropriate.
Yeah.
Just seeing how we're doing. Do you have about 3 more?
Exactly 3 more.
All right. Well, how about 2 more, and then we come back and recap, and then 1 more, and then I have music loaded up.
Okay. Let's do that. Oh,
let's tell your name one more time.
Yes. My name is Marielle. I go by Itumu El Mari. Yeah. Catch me on Facebook and SoundCloud, and those are really the only social media sites I actively update.
You're not on Friendster?
No. Or MySpace, or Periscope. I think Periscope actually died.
Well, I was going to say anything from the 1900s probably is not. I had a friend who actually he was an editor who said he got a live journal to see what the kids were up to. And I'm like, just play a song.
Okay. This one is called Happy Tears.
And so naturally, I tried to subdue my emotions so you wouldn't capture me. Before I even knew you, you made me happy. That's a danger I couldn't let myself see. But one day you chipped away at the exterior I built for myself. Little I knew about like glue. Made a point not to talk every day, but sometimes things just happen that way. Kept in contact through words in our pictures. Then the calls began, light fixtures spinning round above my head as I fall down. And I found myself too late to turn around.
Thank you. Okay, Humbly G, it's time for a song.
One or two more?
We have one, but I don't have to do the last one. We probably won't have time.
Well, I mean, if we talk before the last one, do we talk now?
Yeah, let's just talk now then.
I just wanted to know when to come in, because we always go straight from the last song into the next show.
Okay, then yeah.
So, all right. So, once again, this has been WEF Sessions. I would like to thank Mike Feldman, our sound engineer, Mike Ingram, our booking agent, our studio audience, your accompanists. Why don't we name them off?
Yes, we have Humbly G and 94 Cove. Woo!
And you are?
Itumu Elmari.
And
she has a show on Friday.
Well, once again, let's mention your SoundCloud. Because that's your favorite, right?
Yes. It's just soundcloud.com/Itumuelmari, which is E2UMUELMARI.
No numeral two.
No.
Right.
No.
And now, let's hear about that show Friday.
Yeah.
On Friday, April 14th, in Urbana, you can find this house show going on at Planet Music. You should search for it on Facebook and find the place, because it's like an Easter egg hunt.
And basically. What is the lineup of that show?
The lineup is this guy, D3, who's playing for the first time. You've got Garrett, who's from known around campus. You've got Itumu Elmari. You've got myself and Teacher Freeman of Rogue Tendency. You've got DJ Jacojo. You've got Kenna May. You've got Jarring. It's going to be a good lineup.
All right.
10:30 to 1 a.m. That's $5 at the door.
Now I want to hear what one member of our studio audience will receive.
Whoa.
one member of our studio audience very soon will receive. I'm sorry, there's nothing. There's nothing.
Okay.
It's just failed promises. Sorry.
You just had the announcer thing going.
Too real. Real life. I'm just getting, it's how I'm warming up my voice for the song. It's been a rough week, you know, with the changing in the allergies, the temperature, the changing temperature.
You are the only person in town whose allergies, no one else has been sneezing or coughing or...
Everyone I know and live with.
That's kind of, yeah. Yeah.
This is me at like 90%, by which I mean 100% in comparison.
Good luck even finding any Claritin at this point. I'm pretty sure the stores are sold out.
Everywhere. It's like the zombie apocalypse out there. Maybe not totally...
Let's pick a monster that maintains its identity. Zombies are just kind of so depressing on so many levels.
Pick a better monster that's less depressing.
Todd, all of them,
worried.
Really. I mean,
I'm getting worried about you, Todd.
I don't know. Zombies don't have any identities.
I'm sorry, but if your qualm with the zombie monster is its
they
lack
also
of
eat
mercy,
people.
Then maybe that should just be for
actually,
all villains.
My qualm with zombies is that actual zombies aren't... traditionally, they're not supposed to be dead. They're supposed to be in a state of suspended animation and under a Haitian spell. So we have appropriated zombies much for the worse. If we'd made them cooler, it would be okay. But we did not. We ruined them.
That's true.
We should take it back to the pure original vision that the Cranberries had.
I don't think the Cranberries... Okay, anyway.
I don't like zombies.
High five.
Yeah. I don't like zombies.
And it's okay to not like them because they're not real.
There's just something about them. I just don't like them.
They don't have identities and they're not real. So we're not hating on anybody. We're just saying that they're a bad...
They're just bad.
Yeah.
They're
supposed to be bad. Anyway, so tell us about this. Oh, and please stay tuned through this last song because in the next hour we will have more local music and then the 2-hour tribute to the year 1963 and all the great music from that year, but none of the bad music.
Woo!
So.
Okay, this song is called Floating Through My Head.
Camden Bayer on the harmonica, who I played with for the first time this past week.
Dreams and black and white memories floating through my head. They keep floating through my head. Darker clouds, incredibly loud, fingertips always stealing secrets I allowed.
Don't matter the day, blue, black, white, or sunny. People telling me their life story, but there's no fiction more funny. I'm still grinning ear to ear, thinking of you with me here, wishing it would never end. No, never end.
Turn on the lights inside. Nowhere to hide. Rid myself of these feelings drifting in the tide. Left the pile of ashes on the floor. Oh, oh, oh. Didn't think to look, open the door.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So tight, but late one night, simply walked out, you're gone now, moved on with my life.
It's like I'm back, and you're there with me. Should I have left, I never wanted to leave. Well, neither of us quit, but we both had our dreams, yeah. Kept up with each other but fell out of touch. Anything more might have been too much.
Strung together like 100 pearls.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Looking up at the ceiling as it swirls.
Yeah.
dead, they keep floating through my head.
Thank you.